40 pins or something like that. We have timer 0. We know it already. We know timer 1, 16-bit timer, timer 2. And we have A to D converter, serial interface, SPI interface, comparators, voltage reference, so data flash, and there are even devices with inbuilt drivers for LCD panel. All this is possible with this advanced inner structure. Okay, we must not look to the details. It's a complete handbook with the different features. We have already discussed those features that are of interest for us. Those mid-range core reference book. And there is another reference book.
Reference book.
Wait a moment for upload. This is the MPLAB Assembler User's Guide combined with the MPLAB C compiler description. For us, this part about the assembly C languages. C language is of importance. Assembler overview. And the format of the statements, the allowed characters, and the directives for the assembler program. Directives, you know, tell the assembly program what to do. It's not for runtime. It is for give commands to the assembly to the assembler program. There are a lot of features we cannot discuss. For instance, to create macros, create your own machine language of your own by using macros. A lot of features that are only useful if you use it every day for your normal job, then it makes sense to care about these features. As we already know from 8051 IDE, we get a list file. That means inside the list file there is the source code and the machine code that was created. And we get a hex file. The hex file contains only the machine code and some information about to keep security, so control sum and things like this. And this hex file we can download with the programmer to the hardware. So the hex file is the executable file for a certain hardware. This is the same for PIC controllers, 8051 and so on. The hex file is widely used to program a device. I already told you that we have a problem with the toolchain and MPLAB-X. To program the Curiosity board, we need MPLAB-X for translation and assembly. It's not so good. So in addition to MPLAB-X, we should download the old MPLAB. And both can coexist. You can install both. But run only one at a time. Don't run both together. You can download it. From this page, okay. Here from the archive, we can get MPLAB. We use the MPLAB IDE for 32-bit Windows. Last version was 8.92, but any version 8 will do it. From here, you can download and install. The size of the software is much smaller than MPLAB-X. Okay. Okay. download for later use if it is not already installed, and we will use it to assemble our source code and then try to transfer it to MPLAB X for download to Curiosity board. Okay, I hope I can set up this toolchain today. For our momentary work, you must not look to the assembly handbook. If you have some time, it's useful to have a look to the directives and the features we have. Okay. One last thing, you get the Curiosity board, I think, with LF 1844 6. I think. And we should have a look to this controller. This is an advanced controller. There should be a test program on it. When you power the Curiosity board, this program is running. Waiting for upload. No, it's a big handbook. It's a very big handbook. Okay. This is advanced core. You can see it. From the description, it is C optimized. That means the disadvantages of C compilers are compensated by some hardware or they try to compensate it by some hardware. Again, the tendency to avoid that users program in assembly language, force them to use C compiler, of course, with license. We have 50 instructions. This is due to the C optimizing. We have 32 megahertz clock frequency, and we can have 16 level hardware stack. This is due to C language because the stack is more used with C, and because it is more difficult to do multitasking with C, and we need a lot of timing, we can have a lot of timers. So, 4 8-bit timers, 4 16-bit timers, 2 24-bit timers. So this helps in C language if you have additional hardware timers. Even the watchdog timer is different. It is a windowed watchdog timer. That means we can specify a lower and the upper value for the watchdog timer. And we have a lot of memory, 28 kilobyte memory and 2 kilobyte data memory. So we are not limited to the few bytes in the together with the special function area. Voltage range is 1.8 to 3.6, so it's low voltage with a small power supply, sleep mode 15 nanoamps. And we have 4 configurable logic cells to waveform generators. Okay. We have capture, compare, pulse width units, 4. We can create 4 outputs with defined pulse lengths. We can remap some pins. That means we can define on which pin functions are present. Serial communication is supported with serial interface, with automatic speed detection. We can use SPI and I2C interface to connect to other chips. Okay, the port pins are more flexible than the port pins we know, so then can enabled as open drain, so active pull down. We have timer 0, 1, 3 and 5. We have A to D converter with 12-bit resolution and up to 17 channels. We have a zero crossing detector. This is important to control high voltage thyristor-driven circuits. So triac control is easily possible because we can detect the zero crossing of the line voltage, start a timer and fire a triac to control power. We have inbuilt temperature sensor, two comparators, D2A converter with 5-bit resolution only. Rail to rail means that we reach the supply voltage, no saturation voltage at the high and low end of the scale. This is the housing. And again, the internal core is no longer shown. But enormous number of peripheral functions here to solve a certain problem. Okay, all the details are not of interest, but we should have a look to here we have the core structure. Okay, they hide it in the handbook. We have the 14-bit program bus, 16-level stack. Attached to the output of the arithmetic logic unit, we have the memory, and we have two X registers. This is a second X register for indirect access. Flag register is the same, work register here. All this is the same. So the structure is similar. Thank you. We have to look to the command set. Okay, a lot of hardware. The command set comes at the end. A to D converter.
哇，400多秒了，500秒了啊！放字典了，
哦，
来翻字典给我们看。
什么？
Pass with control。
另外那个哒哒录，给的录哎。
Now we should be close to the end. Logic cells.No description of the command set. Okay, we waste time. I will look for the command set, but anyway, we don't use this processor because it is too complicated. So on the Curiosity board,we can replace with our 648. Okay. Now let's have a look to application. And we compare with 8051 source code.
จะลงยืมไปสิอ่ะ
On the left side, we have the 8051 source code. On the right side, we have the PIC source code. These are not completely equivalent, but in the function similar. Clear bit in 8051. Clear bit. This is a bit address in the bit addressable area. Here we have bit clear in file register. F is the name of the file register and B is the bit position in the file register. Both can be names, symbolic names we have defined before. Here we can reach the whole memory. In each file register, we can access a certain bit. Here we can access only the bit programmable area and the bit programmable special functions registers. So there is a difference between these both solutions. Set bit, bit set in file register. This is not equivalent complement bit. We have a little more problems. We have no command for complement a bit. We have to write a little program. We test the bit and skip the next command if it is clear. We go to here, and here, skip means over jump the next command. And here, we set the bit. And go to exit. So if the bit was zero, was cleared, it is set now, it is complemented. If the bit is high, we don't skip, we go to bit high, clear the bit, and are at the end. Here we can see that sometimes in a reduced instruction set, it needs some more commands to fulfill a function. More easy would be to use control mask word and do exclusive OR connection with the file register. So this would be better than this little program. In this case, here we use the mask word. We get a literal to work register, and here we use a sampler directive. This means shift left a one B times. So if we have bit position one, let's say bit position zero, the result is a one, no shift. If we have B equals two, we have one shift, two shift. And this is a mask word to connect with. Zero, zero. One. One time, two times, yes. And four bits in front. With this mask word, we do exclusive OR connection, and then the bit is switched from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. Here we need only two commands, but it is a little more complicated. So assembly directive or assembly arithmetics helps us with the shift function. Okay, move direct address to accumulator. Source destination. Sorry, this is exchanged. Move file register to work register. The file register, we can use a direct address. And move accumulator to a direct address. Move work register to file register. And here we give the direct address. Move at R0 or at R1 to a direct address means move indirect file register to work register and move from work register to a direct address. We cannot move directly to a direct address. We have only the possibility to choose between destination work register or destination file register. Indirect F you cannot write into, so we have only work register. And from there, we have to move to direct address. Load a literal to direct address means move literal to work register and from work register to direct address. So if destination is another direct address, we always need two commands to do this function. Move direct address to direct address. We get it to work register, and from work register, we move it to the destination. Two commands for this. This is a result of the reduced instruction set. Access to the code memory in 8051 we did with the data pointer. We load the data pointer with a 16-bit address. And then when we have a number in the accumulator, and then we move back from a table in the code memory to accumulator. In PIC assembly language, we do a call command, add the content of the work register to the program counter low part, and make a return with literal in the work register. Of course, we need the call address here. And we have this short subprogram with the label here. And the return is literal and the add command. And exclusive OR and OR command we can process directly. Here we have corresponding command, because destination is accumulator and we can choose the work register as destination. We have a program flow change, jump or not bit, for instance. We address a bit and jump to the label. We have to, again, to process two commands, bit test and skip if set. And we skip, if bit is set, the go to label. if the bit is not set, we do the no skip, we do the go to. So the result is the same as here. The same for jump on zero. We test the bit in the status flag, in the status register, the zero flag. Zero flag in status register, and skip if it is clear, nothing to do. And skip if it is set. This should be skip if set. Here we jump on zero. And to jump, okay, zero flag is one. If the result is zero, if we have one, and skip on, no, was okay. If we have a one here, we don't skip, we skip on clear, but not on set. That means we go to label. This is a function here. Okay, a calculated jump is possible in 8051. Jump to content of A plus data pointer, and the same we can do here. We add the data pointer as literal to the work register, and then move the work register to the program counter. This is equivalent to a jump. Compare and jump if not equal. Compare accumulator with the direct address if not equal. Jump to label. This needs a little more to compare two numbers. We have to subtract the numbers. And to get a bit test, and with the zero flag, while moving, we should not destroy the zero flag, and this we do with this double swap command. And then we can test the zero flag here. Decrement file register and skip if zero. We can solve this with the label, go to label, this is skipped or not. Short jump to label is a go to label. This is the same. Okay, so this is the main differences in the assembly language. Okay, I'll upload this sheet to the cloud, but be careful using it. It's not really a one-to-one description how to translate one assembly language into another assembly language. Such shows some problems of the translation. Okay, now we are ready to go. Okay, first we start with name and so on. Of course, we are in assembly language. Everything that is necessary to identify the software, name, date, function, and so on. Then we have to tell the software which type of microcontroller we are using. And we need all the names already defined for the microcontroller. This we do by an include command, hash include. And now we get a description file. This is P16F, and our controller is 648A. I think it's uppercase. One of the okay, it has the extension include ANC. One of the problems of MPLABX is to find this configuration file.
Is that a good thing out?
This is a microcontroller type.
Cái gì tạo cốt định nhỉ? Muốn xem cụ thể cái gì?
Okay. Next one is a configuration. This configuration is normally set in the program, but you can set it separately as configuration bits in the IDE. This is more flexible. If you set it in the configuration, it looks somewhat like this config. And then we get information about the oscillator. This is internal resistor capacitor oscillator. No clock out, that means no pin is used to output the clock. This is output the clock is a feature of the PIC controllers, but we need all pins, therefore no clock out. And the watchdog timer we switch off, otherwise it's difficult to debug watchdog off.
Chú Long Chí lấy 200 coi à?
And we don't use the reset pin, the memory clear pin. We use this port as input. Memory clear. Off. And this belongs to the programming. I don't know the function at the moment. This is can be automatically generated by the IDE. Okay, this is normally done in the IDE. There you can select the different options.
Mm-hmm.
set configuration bits in IDE. If the whole thing is finished, then we can translate it and include it in the source code. Okay, then we have to tell which memory areas are used.
140.
And we start with the variables.
140.
By we need a white space, root block is 20x. Use the C description for hex numbers 0x20 20x. This is a start address for the variables. If you remember, this memory space was empty. Okay, and now we start with the names of our variables. We have the tick counter. We have the temporary. We have the state pointer. And we have the timeout for the final state machine. Okay, that's enough for the moment. And we have the end of this code block. And the definitions should be located on the left side. Okay. Now we enter a second code block for the flags. We said we located at the address 70 hex. for flex and for save the registers in case of interrupt. In this code block, we have the work register save. We have the status save. Save the flags. Then we have the system flags. So tick flag and things like that. And now supports, out flags. Use right supports. And the inflex. And this is end of code. Okay, these are the definitions. Now we have to define the flex inside the flex register. This is a colon and the number of the flag. Okay. Tick flag. Equals zero. This is bit number zero in flex. And I can access it with flex colon tick flag. So the second flag.
Basketball oder nicht? Nicht bitte. Spielst du Badminton heute? Überhaupt nicht. Ah? Nein. Oh. Kein Spiel. Also du sollst du willst heute entspannen. Oder? Oder du würdest joggen? Ich weiß es nicht.
So fein State Machine Flag.
Essen wir mit Krishna und Quen für das Mittagessen. Das mache ich, aber du solltest CJ und Dixon Fragen stellen.
Ich That's denke, all up to now.
Unnötig. Hallo? Weil sie bestimmt.
Next, we have to define the flex in inflex. Inflex is a logical interface between the drivers and
the
state machine.
Hast du schon Billets, oder? Nein, ich bin Helen. Ich bin nur Helen. Ich bin schon Helen. Mein Kopf ist da.
Mein Kopf ist da. Okay.
Wann soll ich willkommen? Spürst du nicht, oder? Komm schon mal.
Okay,
Bewegung,
flag we always have is push button. Like,
我记得是Verstegen，Verstegen's duo 呀 ，oder nach dem Joggen
and
nach dem Joggen skills
inverted paar Spatten
skills du mit
ja das passt mir.
Ja das.
Nach dem kurzen Joggen. Bitte let Dixon an. Ein.
Nein, ich denke Dixon sollte nicht joinen.
Mitmachen?
Verbinden ist
mitmachen.
Ich denke, Dixon würde nicht mitmachen, wenn du machen.
And also events possible.
Nicht mitmachen. Ich hasse es, dass man die Events
auf der Wand hat.
Events, oder? Ich habe es nicht gedacht.
Or we can have additional definitions. Where we locate inputs, outputs, and support. We will do this later when we need it. We have to define constant values. This we do with equal. So timer. Zero reload.
Schenken. Ein Nachrichten. Zu Krishna Overquen. Vor das Einladung. Vor die Einladung, oder?
Wie?
This should be
something ich denke, am besten,
about for hardware.
Was wenn die schon
3C?
Ich denke,
we need tick load.
Hey! Nanti makan malam, makan bersama. You mana? You boss? Hari ni you boss? Makan mana?
You baru balik mah.
Ya, you boss. Oh. You cakap lain, apa?
About decimal 20.
Okay, big boss yang cakap mah makan itu apa? Nasi kukus ayam.
Ayam.
Nasi kukus.
My mama.
Mama.
Dekat sini lah. Ah, okay,
kami pergi tengok you lah. Number.
Ya. Yeah. Okey, okay, jangan makan malam lah. Nanti cakap oh saya sudah makan bla bla bla.
Okey.
Oh, 7 atau 8 macam tu lah. Between 7 dengan 8 lah.
Okeylah. Then waktu
orang solat dari campus malam. Okey.
Tak mau.
Now we go to the program. And with the origin 0,
mm-hmm.
set the counter that writes the program to the memory to zero. We start with memory address zero. Okay. Next command is go to start, because we have to overjump the interrupt service. We need the interrupt service to reload the timer, and the interrupt service address is at address 4. And this address area we have to overjump. So we write go to start. And then we have three no operations. Now we are at address 4, and here we can start this interrupt service.
The rock service.
The shadow.
Other possibility would be instead of three times no op, origin 4. Makes no difference. Okay, now we go into interrupt. The first thing we have to do is to save the work register. Move work register to file register.
Move work register to file register.
And the name of the file register is work save. This in the register we have defined
earlier
in the upper code block here. Okay. Next, we have to save the flags, because the flags are changed during the interrupt service, and we need back the original flags, because interrupt can happen at any time between conditional jump and the flag change, and this would destroy the program flow. So we have to save
the
flags.
Flag.
The first command, work file register, move work register to file register, does not influence the zero flag. So we can do it before save the flags. Okay, next we get the status flag in the work register. Okay, this command can change the CO flag, but if it is done, so the status register that is saved is without change. And now we can save the work register to the status save register. Work register to file register. Status save. Okay. Normally, we have to pull the interrupt sources. We have to look from which interrupt source the interrupt is coming. If we have disabled all other interrupts, we can say, okay, this must be timer zero, and go to service number zero. No other source. Okay. Okay, we have the timer zero overflow flag in the interrupt control register, and we have to clear it because it is not automatically cleared. Bit clear in file register. Interrupt control. There it is, the timer zero interrupt flag. Okay. Then we have to set the tick flag. In flex.
Tick flag. Tick flag.
Then we have to reload the timer.
Ignore the timer.
Move literal to work register. It's reload value. I'm a zero. Reload. We have defined in line 30 and move it to timer zero. Move work register, file register. Timer zero. Okay. With the move command to timer zero, it is automatically started. We exit the service. This is a normal label. We get back the status register. Move file register, status save.
Move file register to status.
Work register. Then we move work register to status register. Move work register to file register. Status. And from now on, no change of zero flag allowed. Okay. Therefore, to get back the work register, we have to use the swap command. Swap file register work safe.
Swap
to itself. Destination is the file register itself. And in the second command, we swap it to the work register. Swap file register. Work save to work register. Okay. And now we can return from interrupt. And interrupt service is finished.
Interrupt service is finished.
Okay. And now we go to the start label of the program. Okay, I think we have done a lot. We have introduced interrupt to update the timer. And then we have to do the initialization of the timer, of the port, and of the fine state machine, and then we go to the endless loop. Okay, this is enough for today. I uploaded the 8051 example source code, so you can check your exercise 4 if there is some need to change something. Please, not all have uploaded. Last chance to upload till tomorrow. And then we proceed to another exercise. So please upload till tomorrow. And install MPLAB old version, the old MPLAB IDE version 8, so that we can assemble our source code and simulate it and so on. Any question? Okay, there are questions. Um, the three no-op operations to proceed to address 4 in the memory, because this address 4 in the memory is the interrupt service address. If there's an interrupt, we jump to address 4, and there we must have the interrupt service. Okay, these are the three no-ops. We can replace it by origin 4. This has the same influence. So these three memory addresses are empty. The return from interrupt, you can see it in the command list, restores the return address from the stack. This is the basic function of this return command. This is assembly command, the description you get from the command set description. Yes, instead of simply exit, we can write service timer 0 exit. But this exit is for all interrupt services. We have to include additional services, then the exit label is okay. Anyway, we don't jump to exit. It's just a label to give a structure to the return process with restoring status and work register. So there is no need to change it. You can use any name there. Okay, any more questions?
Hey, someone.
No more questions. Okay, then we stop for today, and I see you tomorrow. The version to download is not MPLAB X. Go to the 32-bit section and download the normal MPLAB IDE version 8 dot something. The last version is 32-bit Windows, last version is MPLAB IDE, version 8.92. Yes. Okay. See you.
Oh, 原来是这个 Why nobody?